All right, what's up, everybody? Russ Henneberry here, and in this step, we're going to be looking at something very, very important to any marketer, but particularly a content marketer, and that is creating your customer avatar. So in this step, you're going to need to download the customer avatar worksheet. Should be a link below this video for you, and you're going to fill this out, okay? And you're going to do it for as many different avatars as you need to do for your company. So how many different types of folks are you trying to reach with your content and ultimately your products and services? So the way this worksheet works, if you open it in Adobe Reader and in most PDF readers, you should be able to edit this thing. You could print it and write on it if you want. It's up to you. This is for you, but we have created this so that it is writable. And you're going to give your avatar a name. It could be a normal name, or it could be, you know, a name that sort of identifies the person. In this case, this is one of Digital Marketer's avatars named Freelance Fran. And, you know, we have a number of things filled out about Fran. So Fran has goals and values, right? She wants to win more marketing business. She wants to increase her marketing capabilities. She wants to scale her business. She's committed to providing value to her clients using white hat marketing principles and staying marketable through professional development. Now, that might be exactly you on this call. Now, your name is probably not Fran. You may not even be a woman. You may not live in Boston or even anywhere close. You might be in Australia or, you know, wherever. But you may have a lot of these similar characteristics. Now, you might not be Fran at all. You might be a different avatar that we target, and maybe you're outside of any avatar that we've ever created. But it's important to know who you are talking to. And I like to, as a content marketer, and when I teach people to be better content marketers, I like to tell them, you know, when you are creating a piece of content, who are you talking to? Are you talking to Fran? Are you talking to Eric? Okay, which is another one of our avatars. Who are you speaking to? And you want to almost sit, you know, act like you're sitting at across from them having coffee and having a conversation with them and making sure you're not boring them to death, right? You want to find, what is Fran interested in? What does she want from a content perspective, from a marketing perspective? What does Eric want? What do these different avatars want? And make sure that you are creating content that Fran or your avatar would be interested in. Another great thing to add to your avatar is the types of places that they go to get information. It's particularly good in B2B, but B2C is great as well. And when you are doing things like advertising, this can come in really handy. So you want to get things like books, magazines, blogs and websites, conferences, gurus, and anything other, and get them in here. So like Fran is somebody that likes the book Yourself Solid. She reads Entrepreneur Magazine. She might read these blogs. Okay. And you want to get that stuff in there. And then your demographic information. Now, everybody's not going to fall in, you know, not even close to everybody that's a freelancer or even is going to be, like I said, female and age 30. But this is an avatar that I picture when I'm creating content for this particular segment of our market. I like to put a quote in here. And you don't have to do that, of course. You don't have to do any of it. But I like to put a quote in here because it helps me understand Fran, you know, and it helps me understand an avatar. It's almost like the exercise of coming up with the quote is actually more instructive than having it on the sheet. What do they do? What's their job title, income, level of education? And then I've got space here for other. Challenges and pain points are big, right? You need to understand what the obstacles are for this avatar. And so in Fran's case, she's not able to scale her business. She's not able to offer a wide variety of services. She loses business to agencies. And so pain points, she needs to raise her prices, but she keeps losing. So you want to get in the head of your avatar and figure out what are the challenges and pain points of this avatar, because it will help you to create content. And if it's your responsibility to get involved with creating offers and things like that, you'll also look at challenges and pain points. And then lastly, what are their objections? What's their role in the purchase process? So if they're not going to buy from you, what would be the reason? You know, and so in Fran's case, she needs to know, you know, that she'll be able to recover any money that's invested in training quickly, right? She's not a big, giant agency or a large company, right? So she's not able to just sort of, spend money on professional development willy-nilly. She needs to know that if she buys professional development, which is a lot of what we sell at Digital Marketers, training and professional development, things like that. If she's going to buy that, she needs to know she's going to recover that money quickly. That would be an objection that we need to understand about Fran, and we need to be able to overcome that objection if we're going to sell her any training or anything like that. What is their role in the purchase process? This is important, right? Are they just a decision influencer, right? Are they just influencing the decision to buy, or do they actually make the decision to buy? All right. Important to understand in your marketing and sales process. So in order to complete module one or lesson one of the content marketing certification, you'll want to download the customer avatar. And even if you are just working on a fictitious business, but if you're an employee or if you're an agency and you have a client you can use to build an avatar for, or if you're running your own business, you know, build an avatar of your customer that you're going to use to influence and guide your content marketing strategy in this certification. All right, so that's the end of lesson one. We will see you in the next lesson.